There is a controversy about the $20 bill, about Harriet Tubman replacing Andrew Jackson. A lot of people are saying it's a PC police gone wild. I think it's about darn time. When I was a sophomore in high school, back when high schools actually taught civics, correct me if I'm wrong, we each had a project that we had to write our congressman and our senator and the president to try to get policy changed. And I tried to get Martin Luther King Jr. to replace Andrew Jackson. Andrew Jackson was not a nice man. He supported slavery, he killed a man in a duel, helped commit near genocide to the Native Americans after breaking our word. So he's a liar at that. Or made us as a liar? Harriet Tubman. I don't know that much about her. I didn't know that much about her other than the Underground Railroad. And she's a Christian. Her faith in God as a deliverer helped spur her on. All the abolitionists were Christians. Which makes me think about the politicians who are against this. A lot of them are Southern, a lot of them are white. I'm beginning to believe that not every, but most of the wrong in America is due to the South. I mean, you still have people who call the Civil War the War of Northern Aggression. The war was, yes, it was about states' rights. It was about the rights of states, of Southern states, to own slaves. And it was about money because they wanted more states to be able to be slave states so that they would keep having political power. But William Lloyd Garrison, Frederick Douglass, Abraham Lincoln, Harriet Beecher Stowe, Harriet Tubman, they were all Christians. Jefferson Davis, Stonewall Jackson, Forrest, the KKK. They weren't Christians. They weren't. Christians do not support the enslavement of other people. And they are in Christ Jesus. There is no Greek. There is no Jew. There is no male. There is no female. There is no black. There is no white. Jim Crow. The KKK. Again, the South. Those who are so supporting of these radical gun laws, and don't get me wrong, there are people in rural northern states who are the same, but a lot of it is the South. I mean, guns, the gun and the Bible. That's what they said about Obama said about the South. They cling to their gun and the Bible. You only should cling to one thing. You should cling to the Bible. The gun is a tool of killing. So, again, the South. And the thing is, a lot of people say that, oh, the Democrats, they were the party of racism. That the KKK came out of the Democratic Party. But of course it did. Jesse Helms was a Democrat. Strom Thurmond was a Democrat. Abraham Lincoln was a Republican. But during the 1960s, when the Democrats started pursuing civil rights, you had Nixon playing on that hate, and you had Democrats turning Republican. I mean, look at the map, look at the red. They're almost exactly the same as what would be Democrats in the 1920s, or the states that seceded in the Civil War. And the thing is, I don't care. You like your Southern heritage, fine. But you also say the South is God's country. No, the South is not God's country. And I mean, some of you have repented, but you have switched African Americans to gays. And I understand what you say about the Bible. I disagree. I believe that it is against rape and cultic worship. And I believe the Bible, there's a lot of evidence that says that. But the thing is, you don't show love, you don't show fruit of the spirits, you show hate, you show anger. When we are trying to help the environment, help the planet that God gave us to entrust, you are the ones that decry us, that decry global warming, climate change, that basically support big business polluting our air and our water. The South, almost all. I'm beginning to think the South, there's something wrong with the South. And the thing is, you have Southern heritage, you're proud of your Southern heritage. We're humans. I am not proud of our human heritage. We're sinners. And you should not be proud of your Southern heritage either. I mean, there's a lot of stuff on up in the North that we shouldn't be proud of as well, but the South is just steeping in sin. You're also the ones who are most likely to mention Christ in Christian persecution. But the thing is, people can come to Christ, and all you have to do is repent and come to Christ and be saved. But as long as you stick to your sins, you will die in your sins. God bless.